Anyone who has been following channels for a long time may have noticed that we regularly add the Riyadh Metro to our videos, but in today's video we will talk about this in its entirety. Today is December 31, 2021, and it was open to passengers today, so we thought this topic deserved a separate video. So, in today's video, we're going to look at the Riyadh Metro project, from the beginning to the opening. Number 1. The plans. Riyadh's population will soon grow from 6 million to 8.5 million, and as a result, a solution to the hitherto poor public transport had to be found. The new project is expected to be central to the city's public transport system, integrated with an 85-kilometer three-line bus expressway network. The groundbreaking ceremony was celebrated on April 4, 2014. The capacity of the project is expected to reach 3.6 million passengers per day. In 2018, 68% of the project was completed, and by December 2021, 90% of the project had already been completed, and as work is progressing well, the opening is expected to take place today. 7 tunnel drills with a diameter of 10 meters are used to build the lines. Number 2. Stations. Each station in the network is elaborate and takes advantage of all the possibilities of architecture. In addition, due to the weather in Saudi Arabia, the stations and the subway trains are air-conditioned. The network contains 85 stations. There are 3 main stations within the network. These are Olaya Station, Khaft Station and Kaiser Al-Hukm Station. These are transfer stations, but even the main stations are the Western Station. The stations do not always look like the blueprints, like the Olaya Station, which was originally like that, but eventually became like that. Number 3. The lines. The network includes 6 metro lines. Of these, 2 main lines are Line 1 and Line 2. The longest line is Line 3, which is 40.7 kilometers long and has 20 stations. Each line is double line, consisting of 2 tracks. There are a total of 10 transfer stations where you can transfer between the lines. The lines run both underground and above ground in the form of elevated railways. Number 4. Trains. 3 companies were commissioned to manufacture the trains. Siemens had to produce 74 Inspiro-type trains, of which 45 were 4-car trains for Line 1 and 29 2-car trains for Line 2. Bombardier had to manufacture 47 2-car and over 300 subway trains for Line 3. And Alstom had to produce 69 2-car metropolis-type trains for Line 4, Line 5 and 6. Several parking lots have been built to store and maintain the fittings. The project involves the construction of an advanced center for the management and operation of train traffic, which monitors all elements of the system, including stations, tracks, facilities and systems. It is important to know about the fittings that there will be vending machines. This project cost $22.5 billion and is one of the largest mega projects in Saudi Arabia and the Arabian Peninsula. The system has been tested for the past month and is now open to passengers. In any case, we hope that this project will make a major contribution to speeding up transport in Riyadh. If you liked this video, subscribe and press the bell as well as press a like. See you next time.